Since the release of the second generation iPhone SE, one of the most common questions I've received is why Apple didn't name it the iPhone 9. In fact, many people think it's strange that the number has been skipped altogether. So in this video, I'm going to explain some of the history behind Apple's naming strategies with their products and what influenced their decision to skip the iPhone 9. This is Greg with Apple Explained, and I want to thank Anchor for sponsoring this video. If you want to help decide which topics I cover in the future, make sure you're subscribed, and voting polls like this one will show up in your mobile activity feed. Alright, now let me give you a detailed explanation as to why Apple skipped the iPhone 9, starting with a little bit of iPhone history. Because while many of you know about the iPhone X, you've been pronouncing its name wrong all these years. Although it is an X, Apple intended it to be pronounced as the Roman numeral 10 rather than the letter of the alphabet. And this confusion is nothing new. When moving from Mac OS 9 to Mac OS 10, they also used the Roman numeral 10 in promotional materials, which led to most people calling it Mac OS X. Now, they've since remedied that issue by changing the name of the Macintosh operating system to simply Mac OS, but they decided to reuse the Roman numeral 10 with the iPhone. And again, this caused the same sort of pronunciation issues as with Mac OS 10. But there was an extra layer of confusion with the iPhone, since Apple didn't actually release the device in sequential order. There was the iPhone 7, iPhone 8, and then an iPhone model with a letter in its name rather than a number, something Apple has never done in the iPhone's history. So it actually makes more sense to conclude that the X symbol is actually pronounced X rather than 10. Because why would there be an iPhone 10 if there was no iPhone 9? And why would Apple use a Roman numeral to represent 10 instead of the actual number like they've been doing with every single iPhone in history? The issue was that Apple broke from the traditional iPhone naming scheme they'd been using for years, and the question many of you are probably wondering is why. Well, I'm going to tell you exactly why. It's because Apple prioritizes appealing marketing over analytical reasoning. Why do they call their set-top box Apple TV, even though people who hear that name for the first time assume it's an actual television set made by Apple rather than a box that connects to your existing TV? They still give it that name since Apple TV just sounds cool. And there are many examples of this, like with the iPod or Apple Pencil. Those names can either be misunderstood or misinterpreted since people don't refer to music players as pods or styluses as pencils. But despite this logical disconnect, Apple still uses those names. And that's exactly what happened with the iPhone X. Now, if you own any iPhone that's been released starting with the 8, you have the ability to wirelessly charge your device with something like this PowerWave pad and PowerWave stand from Anchor. What I love about the pad is its sleep-friendly LED indicator that allows me to see the charging status of my iPhone without being super bright like the LEDs in some other products. It can also charge through my phone's case, so I don't have to worry about removing it every night before charging. And Anchor's PowerWave stand is perfect for watching movies and YouTube videos while charging, since it not only props up my phone, but it charges in portrait and landscape, which is super convenient. Plus, Anchor's PowerWave pad and stand support full 7.5-watt charging on the iPhone and 10-watt charging on the Samsung Galaxy, so you don't have to sacrifice charging speed for the convenience of charging wirelessly. So if you want to start enjoying the convenience of wireless charging, click the link in the description. Now, by understanding the approach Apple takes to naming their products, it helps us understand why they were so eager to call their 2017 smartphone the iPhone X and skipping the number 9 completely. There was a significance to the 2017 iPhone release that no other model ever had. First, it was the device's 10th anniversary. The original iPhone was released in 2007, and so Apple felt the need to commemorate the occasion in 2017. Second, the iPhone X represented a completely new era in the device's history. It was the most radical change ever made to the iPhone, and it would also be accompanied by a radical new price point of $1,000, up from the previous iPhone 7's $650 price. So it's safe to say that the iPhone X's release was anything but a routine update. And it was up to Apple to communicate the significance of the 2017 iPhone model's release. That's exactly why they broke from tradition and named it the iPhone 10, bypassing the number 9. It's also why they used the Roman numeral 10, even though Apple had never used a Roman numeral for an iPhone before, and knowing it would likely be mispronounced X. But those things were all irrelevant. Does it really matter if people call it the iPhone X or the iPhone 10? Either way, it communicates the point that this iPhone is completely different than anything Apple has ever done before. And it's certainly not a routine update. Whereas calling it the iPhone 9 wouldn't have been as effective in conveying that message. Now, even though Apple went from the iPhone 8 to the iPhone 10 and then 11, people still expected them to use the name iPhone 9 at some point, which is why rumors of an iPhone 9 model circulated regularly near the end of 2019 and beginning of 2020. We knew Apple was working on a budget iPhone, but were unsure of the name. Many people thought it would be a new iPhone SE, since its rumored $400 price point would be the same as the SE model in 2016, but most people were referring to the budget model as the iPhone 9. So when it was actually revealed by Apple earlier this year, people were surprised that they named it iPhone SE, suggesting that Apple should have filled the gap in the iPhone's sequential history by calling it the iPhone 9 instead. But those people failed to recognize what I described at the beginning of this video. The fact that Apple doesn't restrict themselves to logical reasoning when naming products. They care much more about effective and appealing marketing, since that's what sells products. And by calling their new $400 budget smartphone the iPhone SE, it actually makes more sense from a marketing perspective. Imagine the confusion over a newly released iPhone 9. First, it suggests that the model was released between the iPhone 8 and 10, which would already make it 3 years old in the minds of customers, when in reality, it's a new device. Plus, Apple uses numbers for their more premium iPhone models, but the SE isn't a premium device. It's a budget model intended to appeal to a completely different market than the iPhone 8, 10, or 11. And if you're really bothered by Apple skipping the iPhone 9, I'm about to make you even more uncomfortable. Because that isn't the only number Apple has skipped in the iPhone's history. If you remember back to 2007, there was the original iPhone, and then the iPhone 3G, 3GS, and 4. There was never an iPhone 2. And technically, there was never an iPhone 3 either, since the 3G name came from the device being able to run on carriers' faster 3G networks. Apple didn't adopt sequential numeric names for the iPhone until the 4. The fact that the third generation model was called the 3GS was really just a coincidence. Now, we all know Apple didn't backtrack and release an iPhone 2 just for the sake of filling that number gap. And the same will happen with the iPhone 9. It'll just be another one of those interesting quirks in the iPhone's history that'll continue to be discussed and debated for years to come. Alright guys, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.